Maria Masha Bruskina, member of the Minsk Resistance. Masha Bruskina was born in 1924 in Minsk, Soviet Union. She lived with her mother in Minsk. She excelled in studies and was an avid reader and learner. She was also a pioneer leader and a member of the school committee of Komsomol. In December 1938, the newspaper Pioneer of Belarus posted a photograph of Masha with the caption, "Masha Bruskina, the schoolgirl of 8th grade in Minsk school. She has only good and excellent marks in all subjects." In June 1941, Bruskina graduated from Minsk secondary school. On June 22, 1941, Nazi Germany launched Operation Barbarossa, the invasion of the Soviet Union. The battle on the Eastern Front of the World War II, fought between Axis powers against the Soviet Union and its allies, marked a turning point in the history of World War II. Eventually, serving as the main reason for the defeat of Nazi Germany and the Axis nations. The war on the Eastern Front became the largest military conflict in the history. Most horrific atrocities, highest casualties, mass deportations, starvation, diseases, and massacres. Germany quickly won the battle, and 6 days later, the German army were already in Minsk. After the German invasion in July 1941, Masha and her mother were forced to live in the Minsk ghetto. Almost 100,000 local Jews in a small and overcrowded ghetto before their complete extermination. But some weeks later, Bruskina managed to escape this ghetto to go into hiding on the Aryan side of Minsk, where she lightened her dark brown hair, disguised herself as a Russian girl Anya, and later joined a local resistance group. They planned to rescue wounded and captured Soviet army soldiers from a prison hospital. She volunteered as a nurse at the hospital in the Minsk Polytechnic Institute, which had been set up to care for wounded soldiers of the Soviet Red Army. In addition to caring for Soviet soldiers, she helped them escape by smuggling civilian clothes, medicine, and false identity papers into the hospital. Then the Soviet soldiers would change into civilian clothes and leave the hospital with false identity papers. In mid-October 1941, Russian prisoners planned to escape. Before escaping, the Russian officer who should be leading the escape attempt tells Bruskina to flee Minsk before it's too late. But Bruskina refuses to leave her comrades. However, one patient betrayed her. A patient told the Germans what Bruskina had been doing, and she was arrested on October 14, 1941, by the German Wehrmacht and Lithuanian auxiliary troops. She was tortured and brutally beaten for several days, but refused to name the other members of her group. Bruskina wrote a letter to her mother on 20th October 1941 after her arrest. "I am tormented by the thought that I have caused you great worry. Don't worry. Nothing bad has happened to me. I swear to you that you will have no further unpleasantness because of me. If you can, please send me my dress, my green blouse and white socks. I want to be dressed decently when I leave here." To frighten the people of Minsk and set an example, the German authorities decided to carry out a public execution. On October 26, 1941, Bruskina and two other members of the resistance, 16-year-old Volodya Shcherbachevich and First World War veteran Kirill Trus, were paraded through the streets with a placard around Bruskina's neck, which read in both German and Russian, "We are partisans and have shot at German troops." Members of the resistance were made to wear similar signs whether or not they had actually shot at German troops. Bruskina and her two comrades were hanged in public on 26 October 1941 at the gates of a yeast factory. Maria Bruskina was executed at the age of 17. Their bodies hanged for 3 days before being taken down and allowed to be buried. Antonovna Zhevchik witnessed the execution of Masha Bruskina on 26 October 1941. Before noon, I saw the armed German and Lithuanian soldiers appear on the street. From over the bridge, they escorted three people with their hands tied behind their backs. In the middle, there was a girl with a signboard on her chest. They were led up to the East Factory Gate. I noticed how calmly these people walked. The girl did not look around. When they stopped, one of the fascists started knocking on the door of my neighbor, asking for a chair. But she got scared and did not open the door. In a while, I saw the Germans carrying a stool from the factory ware's booth. The factory gates were wide open. The officer threw a rope on the crossbar and made a loop. The first one led to the gallows was the girl.
Another witness to the execution, Peter Pavlovich Beresenka, said, "When they put her on the stool, the girl turned her face toward the fence. The executioners wanted her to stand with her face to the crowd, but she turned away, and that was it. No matter how much they pushed her and tried to turn her, she remained standing with her back to the crowd. Only then they kicked away the stool from under her." Volodya Shcherbachevich's mother, Olga Shcherbachevich, was hanged the same day as her son, along with two other members of the resistance, in front of the National Academy of Science of Belarus. 2 weeks after Masha Bruskina's execution, her mother was murdered along with other Jews of Minsk in November 1941. For decades after the war, Bruskina's name was not acknowledged on the memorial plaque at the site of the execution. Instead, she was referred to as the unknown girl, allegedly due to antisemitism from Soviet authorities. However, since 2009, a new memorial plaque has been placed at the site of the execution. The Russian inscription now reads, "Here, on October 26, 1941, the fascists executed the Soviet patriots, Truth, Shcherbachevich, and Bruskina." A monument for Bruskina was erected in Hakfar Hairek in Israel, and a street was named after her in Jerusalem. Monument in memory of Bruskina and other Jewish women who fought against the Nazis, Far Hairek, Israel. All hanged partisans were buried in anonymous graves at the cemetery of Kuropaty, Minsk.
Our channel, ThePastQuest. We only post videos about history. Subscribe the channel and support us. Thank you for watching.